Alpine Linux has announced the latest release with Alpine Linux 3.22, brings new features, major updates, and is also dropping some legacy components. So here's what's changed. Let's start things off with the most user impactful change with Alpine Linux 3.22, and that is systemd-efi stub replaces gummy boot. The secure boot-hook no longer supports gummy boot-efi stub. It now defaults to systemd-efi stub, stub only, not full systemd. So this change impacts users relying on gummy boot for secure boot, and also gummy boot EFI stub is now unmaintained and is moved into testing. So, you know, if it's unmaintained, it's not really the best thing to use. So that makes sense. Next up, a look at some desktop environment support, because Alpine Linux 3.22 adds support for GNOME 48, KDE Plasma 6.3, and LXQt 2.2. These updates improve Alpine's flexibility, particularly for those users exploring it as a desktop operating system. For those who are not familiar with Alpine Linux, most of the time Alpine is used inside of containers or in embedded devices and that sort of stuff, because it's very lean in that sense. So it's most often used in that sort of situation. But it also can now be used for desktops for those who are interested. Also, I wanted to show you an article I thought was pretty interesting, is someone testing the use case of Alpine as a desktop OS. I'll have that linked in the show notes. But a quote, real quick quote from that says that I tested this about a week and I found it to be an absolute delight to use as a desktop. I was pleasantly surprised at how much I enjoyed the experience. Now, this is not me. This is someone who is testing this process. So for those who are curious if it works well, apparently it does in Jack's opinion. So I'll have that linked in the show notes for if you'd like to learn more about this test. While Alpine wasn't really designed for a desktop distro, it does suggest that there could be some good setups with this kind of thing. But real quick, just so you know, Alpine Linux, even with the desktop stuff, it's not meant for average users. So if you're a beginner to Linux, you can, you know, just try out something Ubuntu based or something like that, because it's not really for that. If you are an experienced user and you would like to play around with something like Alpine, then feel free to do that. Just a quick warning, I wanted to make sure, just in case it makes people think that they should be trying out Alpine because it's, you know, it's leaner and lightweight and it is all that stuff, but also it might be missing a few packages here and there depending on what you need, because it's not necessarily made for beginners, of course. So just wanted to put that out there. So Alpine Linux 3.22 is here and it is continuing its focus on minimalism and security, but it's also broadening its potential use cases from containers to now even desktops. So if you'd like to learn more, you'll find links in the show notes.